Good evening.
Good evening.
This is the story of myself. A journey in my life where I had to rediscover the true spirit of giving, the heart of giving. Now, ever since I was a child, my parents would encourage me to give. My mother would take out a toy, she would pass it to me. When she passed me the toy, she would say, come on, give to daddy. Give to daddy. That's right, come on, give. I was 3 years old. I had no problem with giving. My only goal at that time, and I only wanted, was to crawl slowly, and put the toy into my dad's outstretched arms. And he, when he received it, he was all smiles. My mom was laughing, she was clapping. Giving was so dramatic, but yet so pure and simple. But as far as my memory would allow, the next time, I remember giving something into my dad's outstretched arms. He wasn't smiling that much anymore. Something happened. What happened, my dear friends? What happened was I learned how to talk. When I give something now, I talk. What did I say? Daddy, I give you something, give me Coca-Cola. The more I learned to talk, the less natural giving became, the more conditional giving became. I would say to my dad, Dad, this test I give you 100%. Then you give me the gaming cards which all the rest of the kids have. And then when my teacher told me that you can forget about 100%, you're not that smart. So I went back to my dad and said, remember the gaming card we talked about? Can you still give it to me if I give you 60%? I know I said 100%, but he said, I can't get it. Can I wash the card? So then, when I became a teenager, my concept of giving became more primitive. Secondary school, I began to see that there was no longer any point to giving. Giving somehow became weak. Now all the kids at that time, all the kids who brought their latest handphones and latest PCBs, they show it off in class, but they don't give it away, right? That made them very cool, very popular. What about those teachers' pets? Everybody has seen those pets before. They have all the answers. But they only give it to you with their knowledge. Because as soon as they give you their knowledge, they don't become the smart ones anymore. In fact, I had a friend at that time who used to be very good to me, used to give me a lot of tips. He changed. One day he just stopped giving, I can't touch his things anymore. And just like that, he became cool. And so, I followed the example. I became a selfish person. It became all about me. Me. Taking, but no longer bothering to give back. Whether it's pocket money, whether it's sweets, whether it is stationeries, whether it's sharing the personal stories, I shut the door on all of them. No more giving. When I stopped giving, two things happened. One, I realized that giving instead of giving what I had doesn't make me full. It made me small. And gradually they began to be this barrier around me that blocks me from everybody else. When I stopped giving for myself, people think, hey, this guy is weird. This guy is antisocial. This went on and on until one day Rediscover came up to me and she asked to borrow my pen. I snapped. And I said, who the hell did you give up? Why should I borrow my pen to you? What have you ever done for me? Go focus on others. That was it. Work went up. And soon enough, I became more and more fearless. I became more and more isolated. Eventually the loneliness gets to me. And my desperation to do something about it, I realized that withholding what's mine is actually driving everybody away from me. When I stop giving, people stop appreciating me for who I really am, for who I really could be. So I decided from then on to give. But I ended up giving in a very, very wrong way, in a very twisted way. I started to give because I wanted attention. What was that like? I was like a mad dog. I think that the only way to know this is by just biting down on people, biting hard, make sure it sticks. Before I give, I make sure that the receiver knows that whatever I give them, I want it back. I want it back. Interest.
Freely, or these people who
willingly and gladly shared their experiences and their possessions with me without even asking anything back. And in Toastmasters, I found one such environment. So gradually my eyes began to open. And I see that when I give this time, I want to make sure that when I give nothing that does not belong to me, it should be there. When I give this, only one purpose, that purpose is to let others enjoy what I've given. This time when I give,
it's 8 o'clock.
This time when I give, it is not about what I get out of my giving, but what others enjoy. So I began to make conscious changes. I began to give differently. I began to give just so I can give. And a profound change came over me. Now I began to give presents to friends I visit, and I don't fuss about the cost. I donate blood. But this time, I don't wonder that, you know, someday in the future somebody will knock on my door and tell me, hey, thanks for saving my life that I owe you. But I don't care about that. If I go to help out for some good cause, volunteer, for some drive, for some charity, I no longer care if I get recognized or not. And when I adopt this new change in my attitude in giving, this new attitude, people begin to come over to me. People begin to come over, and I'm no longer repelling them away. And I began to rediscover there's a whole new world behind the true meaning of giving. In this brave new world, people reciprocate. They willingly give me their attention, they willingly give me their resources, just as long as I do the same to them. Now I remember that there was a time so long ago when I gave openly without pretense, without reserve, without holding back, and I saw that my parents were smiling. They were encouraging me, they were egging me on, give. And I now realize that giving is not about equality. Giving is not about pride, not about pockets. No. Why do we give? We give because it springs from sincere compassion, from sincere care. Yes, giving is actually caring. It connects us all socially. So now when you give, my fellow Toastmasters invited, yes, when you give, do not spoil it by holding it back. Do not spoil it by making giving about yourself. Give freely. Give generously. Give naturally. Back to you, Toastmaster.